Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we saw some properties of parallelograms and some examples based on them. Today, we will solve some more questions related to that. Let's start with the first question. Prove that if a diagonal of a quadrilateral bisects the other diagonal perpendicularly, then that quadrilateral is a kite. Friends, first of all, let's draw a figure according to the statement. Suppose ABCD is a quadrilateral and diagonal AC is bisecting diagonal BD perpendicularly at point O. We have to prove that quadrilateral ABCD is a kite. Friends, if in a quadrilateral two distinct pairs of adjacent sides are equal, then that quadrilateral is called a kite. So if we prove that side AB is equal to side AD and side CD is equal to side BC, then it will be a kite. So let's take triangle AOB and triangle AOD. Here, side AO is the common side. We are given that diagonal AC is bisecting diagonal BD perpendicularly. So angle AOB is equal to angle AOD, each being right angles, and side OB is equal to side OD. Thus, these triangles are congruent according to the SAS congruence rule. The corresponding sides of congruent triangles are equal, so side AB is equal to side AD. Similarly, we can prove side BC to be equal to side CD. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a kite. Now let's take the next question. On the given figure, quadrilateral PQRS is a rhombus and the measure of sides QR and OQ are given to be 5 cm and 3 cm respectively. Now find the length of diagonal PR. Friends, first we will take into account all the properties of a rhombus. A rhombus is also a parallelogram whose opposite sides are equal and parallel. Diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other perpendicularly, that is, triangle QOR is a right angle triangle. By taking triangle QOR, we can find the length of side OR using the Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle QOR, the square of side QR will be equal to the square of QO plus the square of side OR, according to the Pythagoras theorem. Now, if we keep the value of these sides, we get OR is equal to 4 cm. And since PO is equal to OR, therefore PO will be equal to 4 cm. Diagonal PR is equal to PO plus OR. Therefore, we get the length of the diagonal PR equal to 8 cm. Now let's move to the last question of this session. In quadrilateral ABCD, side AB is parallel to side DC. Side AB is equal to side DC. Angle BAC equals 40 degrees and angle B equals 80 degrees. Find the values of angle DCA and angle D. Friends, we know that when a pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal and parallel, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. According to the question, side AB is equal and parallel to the side DC. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So, angle B will be equal to angle D because the opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. So, angle D will also be 80 degrees. And since side AB is parallel to side DC and AC is the diagonal, therefore angle BAC will be equal to angle DCA as these are alternate interior angles. Therefore, angle DCA will also be 40 degrees. Friends, let's end this session here. In this session, we solved some questions related to some properties of a parallelogram. See you in the next video. Thank you.